focuses on cutting-edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class businesses.
Big Tech.
Without
GTI,
you are not supposed to enter this job.
I can see
Yes.
Your meeting in the in connection with on the backdrop of the two-day Mahamanthan, the so-called Mahamanthan, the plenary of the Congress. There are several points on which I wish to respond and in fact raise questions. They are derived from the political, the economic resolution, and also from these speeches of the eminent speakers. And therefore, it's going to be a mix and match response from my side. But of course, essentially taking from all the comments which have been made largely by their party president and also the chairperson, if she's called that, Mrs. Sonia Gandhi, and briefly responding to the other speakers. I do not want to start, but I'm for want of saying anything better to start with, I want to say. It sounds like a rhetoric of a loser. Devoid of substance, but yet, although it's devoid of substance, I would want to respond to some of the points that they've been raising, which are not substantial at all in a political debate, but still. Kaurava and Pandava, and who are the Pandavas, who are the Kauravas? Look at this. Who's deciding on the Congress to be the Pandavas? A party which in this free independent India imposed the emergency. Has been solely responsible for the Sikh riots. Anti-Sikh riots after the Blue Star, after Mrs. Indira Gandhi's death. A party which had to be thrown out of power because they were clearly involved in about 12 lakh crores of corruption, which are at various stages in different courts. If this country is saddled with a problem in Kashmir, thanks entirely to Congress Party. Which party during emergency had made newspapers print front blank pages, black column pages, completely locked up everybody in the prisons, opposition party, media, in all capacities, media persons were all put in behind bars. Also cried over terrorists' dead bodies. And a party which whose president today says, I go here, I go there, I also go for Mandir and Masjid and everything. Who questioned the very existence of Sri Ram. As you would say it in Hindi, Astitva, Ram ki Astitva. You question, and this party chooses to be called, labels itself, Sri Ram, a party which question the fundamental existence of Sri Ram, today wants to be identified with the Pandavas. And even worse, it's a party which chooses only to market the Hindus and Hindu rituals always. Even today they didn't lose out on an opportunity. In the little episode that he narrated about, he went to a Congress pundit and a BJP pundit, asking the meaning of rituals. chooses to make a mockery of Hindu rituals. Never lose an opportunity to hit at the Hindus. Something to the effect of BJP is continuously losing one after the other elections, and therefore Modi ji is worried and a scared man now, whereas we are winning one after the other elections. Something to this effect, he concluded his speech. How do you respond to this kind of a factually completely inappropriate conclusion? And this is Mahamantan, imagine. This is Mahamantan. They have concluded that BJP is losing election one after the other, whereas Congress is winning, and as a result, Prime Minister Modi is scared. Just for record's sake, even if the two by-elections in UP that we lost, and on which the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh has come out and graciously said, yes, we've lost, we learned lessons out of it, but we know what cost it. Let's not miss the point. Congress lost its deposit in both these places. One after the other, they are winning elections. After losing a state government, they said they had a moral victory. Here they have lost the deposit. And he says one after the other, he is winning elections. And this is president of the Congress party. So, when I said it is a rhetoric of the loser, I'm not sure it is too far from it. How many cases were put against the media? Hundreds of cases against the media. And Mrs. Indira Gandhi mocks the judiciary, corrects the independence. Rajiv Gandhi brings in this press defamation bill, has several cases put on the media, but today, the grandson and the son of Indira Gandhi ji and also Rajiv ji talks about protecting the judiciary, taking care of the judiciary's independence, and also trying to protect the media, saying, don't worry, I'll come to power and take care of you. Don't forget the press. Before the clash, people of this country will ask you. Friends, eventually we should understand that it is a 48 years of misrule of Congress, either directly or through remote control, versus the 48 months of clean, committed, and absolutely for the welfare of true India, new India, that the government is running today. 48 years of misrule versus 48 months of great rule by the BJP, led by the Modi. If for 48 years of misrule, all the allegations are being thrown at us, the BJP, which is striving hard to give clean administration in 48 months, the Congress party has a long way to go to prove all that they've done for this country. And this kind of a language of a loser, rhetorical language of a loser, is not going to take them anywhere. Name calling is not going to take them anywhere. Pretentious support to judiciary or media, when your history and your record shows differently, doesn't even give you credibility. So the Congress party's Mahamantra, based on the series of victory that they are imagining for themselves, having lost a possibility, and accusing the BJP, which actually is winning, saying just shows how this Mahamantan resulted in nothing but fakery. I want to end by saying the Congress party has stuck to its agenda. And that agenda is to peddle fakery. Let's not forget, there are 7, 8, 9, 10 cases that I can give you, probably even a compilation of about 13 cases I can give you, where they've given fake stories. Fake news, fakery. They've kept on with fake news and fake stories. And they've peddled them with sheer impunity. One such which doesn't leave my conscience is during the demonetization, they show an ex-army man, I think, standing in a queue and crying. They peddled the story in spite of
That very ex-army man telling, Baba, it wasn't anything at all. Somebody stepped on my foot and I screamed saying pain in my leg. He has come out himself to Congress ke adhyaksh Shri Rahul Gandhi, Bharatiya Janata Party ke adhyaksh Shri Amit Shah ji ko murder accused ke shabd ko upyog karte hue refer kiye hain, jo kanunan galat hai kyunki CBI court ke dwara unka bari kiya gaya hai. That has been removed, that allegation has been thrown off. वैसे भी वो allegation भी एकदम फेक है और फ्रॉडुलेंट है, कॉन्स्पिरेसी है, जानसाजी है. उनको फंसाने के लिए कोशिश हुआ जो कोर्ट के द्वारा आज सफाई भी आ गया. मुझे ये कहने में संकोच नहीं है कि कांग्रेस पार्टी के अध्यक्ष जब कोर्ट के द्वारा फैसला होने के बावजूद भी बीजेपी को अध्यक्ष को ऐसे अभी भी वो एलिगेशन डाल करके बोल रहे हैं, तो ये अंग्रेजी में तो इसको मैं ब्रेजन बोल दूंगी, हिंदी में आप ढूंढ लीजिए उसका उचित शब्द. और ये एलिगेशन बोलने वाले कौन है जो खुद उनके मां और माताजी और वो दोनों पर्सनल बॉन्ड में बेल में बाहर घूम रहे हैं, वो भी क्रिमिनल कॉन्स्पिरेसी नेशनल हेराल्ड के केस में 50,000 का बेल पर्सनल बॉन्ड देकर के बेल दिया गया होगा. जो खुद बेल में है वो डाल रहे हैं जिनके ऊपर एलिगेशन कुछ भी नहीं है, कोर्ट के द्वारा साबित हो गया है वो. आज आप देख लीजिए कि मुझे डर लग रहा है कि अध्यक्ष कांग्रेस के द्वारा ही ऐसे बेबुनियाद बातों को सामने रखा गया. और हिंदुओं को जो लगातार कांग्रेस पार्टी तो करते आते हैं, मगर अभी भी इस मौके में भी, एक फोर्थ प्लीनरी में भी, महामंथन के समय भी हिंदू धर्म को अपमान करने में दे डिराइव प्रेशर उनको अच्छा लगता है. वो छोटा सा कहानी बोले, शायद कहीं एक मंदिर में गए जिसमें कांग्रेस के पुजारी बैठे हैं, कांग्रेस के पुजारी और हिंदू बीजेपी के पुजारी मैंने अभी तक मेरे जीवन में नहीं देखा, मगर उनको मिलता है ऐसे भी, कांग्रेस के पुजारी और बीजेपी के पुजारी. और उनके कहानी बोलते बोलते ये बात बोले कि वो बीजेपी के पुजारी इनको मिला, जो वो बोले कि उस गुंबस को कुछ या उस दीवार को कुछ सोने में लपेट लो, आप प्रधानमंत्री बन जाएंगे, ये ऐसे कुछ बोले. हिंदू धर्म को मॉक करने के लिए, मजाक उड़ाने के लिए उनको कहानी मिल जाता है. मगर मैं उनको एक सुझाव देना चाहती, कम से कम अभी से ढूंढने में अच्छा पुजारी को ढूंढे जो फेक नहीं है, जो अंग्रेजी में बोलते हैं इज नॉट अ यू नो फ्रॉड और व्हाट अबाउट फेक पुजारी को बोलते हैं क्वैक्स, फर्जी पुजारी को ढूंढोंगी पुजारी को ढूंढने ढूंढना नहीं है, अच्छे पुजारी को ढूंढ लो भैया, आपको सच बोलेंगे शायद. हिंदुइज्म चाहिए मजाक उड़ाने के लिए, बार बार हिंदू धर्म के का अपमान क्यों करते हैं कांग्रेस? अपीसमेंट का दूसरा यू नो द अदर साइड ऑफ द पॉइंट.